Hello everybody, this is FC7, and today I am sharing my playthrough of the Ranger Epic 2.0, Aurora the Heartwood Blade. It has now been a full 4 years since I uploaded the first step of this quest, which was the Epic 1.5, that was the regular Heartwood Blade. So now, 4 years later, I have finally gotten around to finishing the 2.0, and it all starts in Nadiria's Landing. So here we are in Nadiria's Landing, and the first step is to find the Wayfarer's brother officer. So right when you zone in, this is zoning in from one of the LDON teleporters. So there we go. So you just hail this officer. Here is her location on the map, and she wants you to find out some information about some missing adventurers. So the very first step in finding the missing adventurers is going to Noble's Causeway, and you need to find a mob named Siflu, and you need an item called the Heated Lodestone. So I am doing this as a level 111 ranger, so I am massively overleveled for this quest. So there are some things that need to just be explained about this. Normally, if you do this at the required level, you would fight him until he was low on health, and then he would un-aggro you, and you would ask him about the adventurers. Just say, what adventures, and he would give you the Heated Lodestone. Unfortunately, if you're like me, and you're massively overleveled for this quest, you needed to do it a little bit differently. So now, what worked for me is just taking off my equipment, unequipping it. That's the two main weapons in your primary. I also took off the range weapon. And turn your back to the mob. Hail him, have him aggro you. Make a hotkey that asks what adventures, and then he'll give you the Heated Lodestone. Now, you have to be careful. I'll show you what I did my very first attempt here. Okay, so this is my first attempt. I have all my weapons equipped, and I hail him. Well, first I have to uninviz. So he basically died instantly, and I think it's from one of the ranger's abilities. So my second attempt, I'm going to make a hotkey that says, what adventures? Just put that in here. And just name it whatever. Just type it out. Now I will unequip my primary, my secondary, and my range. And beware, if you screw this up, it's like a 2-hour respawn form. So I had to wait 2 hours between attempts here. So now I'll just take off and viz. He'll aggro me. I will say what adventurers, and he continues to aggro for a while, but he did give up the lodestone. And for some reason he just despawns, which is good. So now it's on to the next step. So it should just appear on your cursor, and then make sure it's in your inventory before you move on to the next step. And the next step will be in the Wall of Slaughter. So in this part, you will need to kill a mangled Myrmite captain and loot the Traveler's Journal and Spirit Manacles. Here's a location on the screen, and I'll just run there quick. And as you get closer to where he spawns, you should see an emote like your Heated Lodestone gets warm for a moment in one of your windows. That should indicate that he spawned. It's not too difficult. He spawns with two aged Ukans, as well as the rest of the trash in the zone. Might be a little difficult if you're not a high level. So he spawned right here. I didn't even get a chance to see him. And he aggroed me right away. I had my healer mercenary up just in case, but we didn't need him. So there's the journal. And the manacles that are up here somewhere. There was an emote about the lodestone. So just loot that, and I think I'll take this AUG. Not part of the quest, but I should loot it. Here's the manacles. Okay, now for this next part of the quest, you have to go to the Wayfarer's brother again, the officer, and hand her the journal. But unfortunately, as of right now, November 10th, 2021, the step is bugged. And looking over the comments on Alakazam, it looks like it's been bugged for about a year now. You're supposed to hand it in to her, the journal, and then she's supposed to give you an emote about thanking you for discovering the fate of the adventurers. But no matter what I did, I couldn't get her to accept the journal. Luckily, in one of the comments on Alakazam's, somebody said that a GM just told him to go on to the next step and just ignore this one. So that's what I did, and it worked. So the next step here is in Torgon Mines. And you have to loot a cricket cage. And I'm just showing the area at the zone in here where it dropped for me. It can drop from a Delirious Miner or Broken Skull Bruiser. Are probably any of these, but I just went in and just cleared the zone here, the zone in, and eventually it dropped. So it dropped from a Broken Skull Bruiser for me right in this area. So I don't think you have to go too deep in the mines, just stick to where the slaves here are. So I'll just loot that and move on to the next part of the quest. Now, on to the next step, you'll need to head to the Plane of Fire and the Plane of Water and get two living fragments of fire and water. We'll start with the Plane of Fire here. You'll need to loot a living fragment of fire, and they drop from the Mephits. I find them, or I found them in, near the zone in. There's a bunch of them. And just slaughter as many as possible until it drops. This step didn't take too long for me. It was pretty quick. So the step coming up with the living fragments, a lot of it has to do with if you have your Epic 1.0 or not on your Ranger. And I'll explain more about that later. Here's the living fragment of fire. I'll just loot that and move on to the plane of water. So, next step, looting a living fragment of water. And that is in the plane of water, drops off of Mephits. This was actually the most time-consuming part of the quest for me. I spent a lot of time here. But eventually it did drop, and I'm going to show you the location in a second. So there's the living fragment of water. And the area it dropped for me at was right here. Not too far back in the zone, kind of near the front in the middle. So just loot that. And now comes the part with the combine. And the combine all depends on if you have the Epic 1.0 or not. Okay, if you have the Epic 1.0, here are the ingredients you'll need to make the next step of the quest, which the spirit cage. If you don't have the Epic 1.0, here are the ingredients you'll need to make the spirit cage. All you'll have to do is loot a living fragment of air and a living fragment of earth, and use those in place of the two epic parts. So since I don't have the 1.0, I'm going to Plane of Earth and looking for the fragment of earth, the living fragment of earth. Here I am at the Zone Inn. And you have to go back by the castle area where the frogs spawn. So I'll just show you. Just take a left from the Zone Inn and go down the wall here. I'm not exactly sure if you need to go to the castle, but this is just where I found it, and that's where a lot of the suggestions were on getting it to drop. So this is for the alternate recipe for making the spirit cage. I just gathered up a lot of mobs in this area and just DPS them down. So a lot of them do summon. What I will do is just, since I have a large amount of them, just DPS them. And in this big collection of loot, there's two of them. Let me just see what this is quick. I know that one of these frogs drop an illusion, a pretty cool looking illusion. But that's not what I'm here for. Maybe I'll come back someday for that. Just loot this living fragment of earth and move on to the next step in the plane of air. So, looking for the living fragment of air. And the Mephits are kind of near the zone in, past the front yard. So again, I'll just gather a bunch of mobs here. And I think the Mephit, the model, is that one that looks like a fly, the one with wings, the blue one. Luckily, I had this drop for me right away almost. It didn't take too long. I didn't have to spend a lot of time here. But I can imagine back in the day when this was new content that this would have taken forever. So the Temple Guardian, it dropped from him. There it is. I'll loot that and move on to the next step, which is creating the spirit cage. Here are the ingredients, the alternate recipe, so just open the Crooked Container, put in the needed items, hit combine, and that should create the spirit cage. If you use the main recipe, you should get your two epic items back. So now on to the next area. The next zone is in Rift Seeker's Sanctum, and you'll need to loot the Ring of Warmth. I will show his location. It requires going up the stairway here. This always has been one of the cooler looking zones in EQ. It's not too easy to find locations because of all the levels, though. There's like two or three levels, maybe more. So some information about Craftmaster Terenu. He hits for 2500 and has a single target rampage. He also spawns adds, the higher levels of which come with the 1500 point AE. I'll just find him here. No match for a level 111 ranger. So here's his location. Let's get rid of these guys. So there he is. And there's the ring. Just loot that, and I think a chest spawns here too. Maybe if you have an alt, maybe be some decent loot. On to the next and almost final step, that is the Wall of Slaughter. You need to loot the Harfrost Wand. And that is from Harian Warfrost, and I'll give his location here. It's almost to the MPG zone line, right about here. So there he is. He spawns with three adds. And he was probably the most difficult part of this quest, only because he has a 10-second stun. I thought that I could just sit back and just do some ranged DPS, but he summons, so. Once I got into melee range, he hit me with a stun. So the stunning made this time consuming. As you can see, I'm just sitting here. It would almost be nice if they added some kind of level to the stun. It's not really doing any damage, it's just like you sit there and don't do anything. But in between the times you're not stunned, you can do some damage here. So, in the interest of time, I'll just skip over a lot of this fight. I was hoping to show full duration fights for this video, but this just drags on. And here he is, almost defeated. So loot the wand, and then do the combine. So there's the wand. And here is the recipe for making the Elemental Ice Spirit Cage. The next step requires actually going into Anguish, the Asylum of Anguish, and doing the combine in the last step there. You'll also need the Globe of Discordant Energy, of course. I'm not gonna describe how to get that in this video. I do have a video in my channel library on how to go in there and solo it. So there's the Globe of Discordant Energy I've had for a while, probably a few years now. Just using it now. Once you combine it, the Spirit of the High Air will appear. And remember, you have to do this in Anguish itself, so you'll need five more people or five alts to help get you in this instance. So you hand him your Heartwood Blade, which is your Epic 1.5, the Elemental Ice Spirit Cage, and the Globe of Discordant Energy. And that will finish the quest. Overall, it was a pretty easy quest. Luckily, there were no trade skills involved. That can be time consuming. It took me around an afternoon to do this. Nothing was too hard to find. So there's the achievement that pops up. And there's the blade. It has some really neat looking particles to it. I think, if I remember right, I was kind of disappointed in the regular Heartwood Blade when I did that video. It was kind of plain, but this one has some cool looking lightning on it. Along with the achievement, you also get 10 AA points, which is nice. So that's about it for this video. I might be back with one of the epic requests. I think I have one left to do, and that's the epic retelling, where I can get this epic made into an ornament. So look for that in the future. I hope this video helps somebody. Even if it's not for somebody's use, it is helpful to have some of these great old quests archived. So I hope I'm doing my part with that. All right, so everybody have a great day, and like and subscribe.